Hello everybody, and a happy new year to you if you're watching this when it goes up. If you're watching it later, where the hell were you? But anyway, donning the hat one last time for this year as we're gonna take a quick look at Violent Night. This was directed by Tommy Vercola and stars David Harbour and John Leguizamo. Harbour plays a very disgruntled Santa Claus who has become just sick to death of the commercialization and greed that has overtaken what used to be such a happy, joyous holiday. And as he is making his rounds on Christmas Eve, he ends up in the house of a very, very rich family. Most of the people in this house are definitely on the naughty list, as they are quite horrible, except for a young girl named Trudy, who is actually on the nice list. And as these people are celebrating, no, that's not really the right word for what they're doing. As they are gathered in accordance with the holiday tradition, the house is invaded by a bunch of criminal thugs who want the rich people's money. And it's up to jolly old Saint Nick to kick ass, take names, and save the day. The idea of Santa Claus brutalizing a bunch of criminals is very silly on paper, and in practice, it's still very silly, but it's actually really well done. The story is really good and shows a version of Santa that you would not normally see. He's tired, he's angry, he's often intoxicated, and has very much lost the Christmas spirit for totally understandable reasons. And Harbour is so good in this role, whether he's happy Santa, angry Santa, drunk Santa, he's hilarious. And I really like the bond that forms between him and Trudy, who's played by Leah Brady, and amidst all this ongoing violence, she is still able to remind him why he does all of this. You can see his spirits are lifted almost as soon as he comes down that chimney and finds those homemade cookies and the candy cane that she left out for him. The skim milk was a bad call, though. And of course, as soon as you see that candy cane, you know that Chekhov's candy cane is going to come into play later. And it is glorious when it does. And for much of the movie, Santa and Trudy are not face-to-face. They're conversing over walkie-talkies, but their conversations are actually very sweet, considering just how violent this movie is. There's a lot of the Christmas spirit in this movie, even though it's very much a hard R, and Santa has to cross a lot of names off that naughty list. And he's able to do that because this version of Santa has a very violent past. And I'm not referring to the legend of St. Nicholas of Myra beating up the Arian priest. That's Arian with an I, by the way, not with a Y. Although, Santa beating the crap out of Nazis would be awesome. How has that not been done yet? No, this version of Santa used to be a Viking raider, apparently, and had this massive warhammer called Skull Crusher. It lives up to its name. They never really explain how he went from Viking raider to Kris Kringle, but maybe if they ever make Violent Night 2, we'll get some of that backstory. As for the people that Santa is trying to save, apart from Trudy, they make up the typical variety of assholes you would expect to find in this rich family. There's the brother Jason, who is kind of the cowardly one that's stuck under his mother's heel. There's the sister Elva, who is just pure unadulterated greed. Her husband is this wannabe action movie star who is so full of himself, and he's played by Cam Gigande, who was unfortunately featured in some of my very early reviews, but I really liked him in this. He was funny. And Beverly D'Angelo plays the family matriarch Gertrude, who has no time for any of their shit, or indeed anyone's shit. I'm pretty sure this woman came out of the womb without a fuck to give, and she is ruthless. Jason's wife isn't too bad. I think really the only mistake she ever made was marrying into this family. How such a sweet kid like Trudy can share any DNA with these people is beyond me. There's a pretty funny moment where we actually see all of the criteria that got her on the nice list. It's like, trustworthy, kind to animals, invited the weird kid to a party, which I really like that line. Trudy, on behalf of weird kids everywhere, thank you. And of course, we have John Leguizamo as the villain, who is very dangerous and also very funny. This is clear from the moment he makes his grand entrance into the house singing Violent Night as his own twisted version of Silent Night. Hey, that's the name of the movie. And I like how he and his henchmen all have holiday-themed names. He goes by Scrooge. Some of his henchmen are Krampus, Frosty, that kind of thing. And there's a part of his backstory that kind of involves him not really getting what he wanted for Christmas one year, and that turning him into the horrible person he is today, which is really dumb and should not work, but somehow it does. And of course, you would expect a movie called Violent Night to have plenty of violence, and boy, does it live up to its name. Santa's beard is stained red for almost the entire movie, and the henchmen suffer some absolutely brutal deaths, and we even get a bit of a tribute to Home Alone, although the injuries are a bit more realistic and not nearly as cartoonish. And the fights are shot very well. Vercola does not rely too heavily on quick cuts. He is totally willing to just point the camera at two guys and let them beat the shit out of each other. And it works. Overall, very fun, very violent, manages to balance the bloody moments and the sweetness pretty well, and I would say this is worth seeing at any price. I can definitely see this being one of my new go-to movies for holiday viewing in the future. And that's all I have to say about Violent Night. Till next time, take care.